trim style, we could roll out towards the leading gear. I think what you're going to be needed to come to is a sort of control, is that which that is. There can't be a transition phase, because that would be extremely hazardous. You don't agree that on certain nights we go in here. At midnight, yeah. We adopt the Indian style, which is better than ours, and there are no rules. There are no police patrols, no highway wobbles, nobody's allowed to close it for any reason.
It might take some bedding in, as an idea. No, I said, in the first 6 months, it might be a bit of...
Are you dead?
No, absolutely.
You are nobody
good, but you're dead. No, I'm not dead. Also, I think I'd actually maintain the reasonable speed. I think your average speed is as good as it is at the airport.
Well, the airport, yes, yeah. The airport's rubbish. But the airport's rubbish because they code it off. They've got their code
rubbish. These rocks are set of code in there. There's not a little money. Broken down, rocks
rubbish. Rocks rubbish, so that motor's tired.
Rocks the expected effect of
that. It's a lorry ahead, but they only put a rock a yard away at motor's tower.
Yeah, so basically we've had a crash with a rock very close to
the road. Yeah, the idea that you see a rock, but not a massive idea. They also put a branch sometimes on the road. That's just courtesy.
That's nice.
I'm talking about courtesy. I'm talking about a road network where, admittedly, there's a few hundred thousand people are getting the test. Here's a drawback.
Might be the only white people they ever see. Romania? They're making fun of, is it a him or her? That could be Newfoundland.
Shall I tell you some things that I know about the Amish?
Yeah.
Amish people aren't on, they're not on the internet, and they're not on, they don't even draw electricity from the pilots because they don't want to be connected to what they call the English. You know the Cambodians call everyone foreign
French. Yes.
Everybody is French, whether you're German or American, everybody's French here. In Amish land, everybody who isn't Amish is English. So today they're going to say, you English, and we're going to say, yes.
Yeah, yeah. This is the first place you can pull over and stop in intercourse, isn't it? I'm going to call this, sorry, this has never happened before. That wasn't Harrison. No, they're Amish. Do they think Amish? Do they have any North of English?
They're
not fighting or stabby.
Why would they be fighting or stabby? They're not fighting or stabby. They could be. Local paper. I started on the offering advertiser.
It's not a very long newspaper, is it? It's in the cover of 2 pages, isn't it? Take 20 seconds to read that.
I can explain using this why 563 horsepower in my car is better, much better than 562 yours. One horse difference, yes?
Yeah.
The horse and the buggy. Remove the horse, useless.
Yes.
So one horse makes all the difference.
Yeah, if you've only got one,
you're not
taking away 100% of the horsepower, which you're not doing by taking one away from me.
One horse.
Your logic, Danny, is different. Brilliant. So it's high. That's a very fly way to take wrong.
This is exquisite. $15,000, please.
Sorry. Yeah, I love it. Absolutely fab.
Headlamps, indicators, hazard warning lights.
It's quite nicely done, I have to say. For local journeys, it's absolutely fabulous.
Is that a carbon fiber pebble?
No, no. Is it? Is that a goat? It is. I like a goat.
I like a goat.
Not be a local car, if it were, somebody by now would have written ish. The Myra. Chance. The Myra, I'm right. I told him that he's gone.
Yep.
Are you Amish?
Mennonite.
What's the difference?
The Amish separated because the Mennonites were too different.
Oh, so you're quite, you watch TV and things.
Yes.
Have you got a car, or do you go around in a horse and car?
I have a car.
You got a car? No Amish would have a car, would they?
They do, before they're baptized into the Amish church. They will have driver's licenses, they will drive cars, and... there's an old saying, they always hide in the barn under his
head. But we also witnessed it, the most likely people in the barn, I remember that.
When you get married, you're officially in the Amish church, and you can no longer drive a car.
And the Amish generally, the young Amish kids will drive...
Ford Mustangs.
They really know their things, their horseplaces are.
Yes.
So the Amish carriages, they got batteries in them.
They do. It is required by state law that they have headlights and flashers. and they will turn on a dust and turn signals just for safety.
And here's one now. So that, oh, I see the box underneath it. It's got a battery in it.
We also have more expensive models with stainless steel beds.
How expensive is one of those?
Around $15,000 to $20,000.
You could buy a Honda for that.
Oh, I know.
Who's cars?
It's when you get married, you like to start out with the best. And
well, that's a car.
It is.
With hundreds of horsepower rather than one.
Oh, but this has to last you your entire life.
That will last a lifetime.
You do not get rid of it. It's basically you owning a Ferrari. That's their version of riding a luxury.
That's cool. Very educational. Ferrari. Not Lamborghini.
It was honest and simple. It was refreshing. It's broken. I know you're supposed to give the knockout the cost, but it was €4,000. Eventually, we pulled over for a spot of Romanian lunch, where for a change, Jeremy had an opinion on something. Can I just say as well, James?
Yeah.
You brought the wrong car.
I'm not interested.
No, it's true.
What's wrong with it?
Because it's a supercar. These are cars are proper cars. They've got boots at the back engines and they're proper cars. But they're also, they're the worst step up from the Mercedes SL or BMW 6 Series. They're that sort of unlock there.
So what cars are doing in that car that you can really
want? We're going to be less comfortable in that than we are.
And you can't drive around with that looking slight like you're trying to imagine you're on a racetrack. You're not going to have a lot of them
in. And every time you want to put a suitcase in it, you're going to have to lift the front up. And you're going to get dirty hands.
I can't drive around with that looking as if I think I'm on a racetrack. Exactly. Since they're in the Ferrari. It's going to be all mine going on.
It's actually taking
the car. Do you remember the days ago? Olivia was telling me, well, that's a car, but actually it's a GT.
Do you remember George's and Victoria's went on grand tours in Italy? Did they go on sports horses or long local horses?
Is it the old track?
Yeah. Well, I think George's did.
Okay.
So they wouldn't go on a sports horse, they would go on a comfortable carriage. Like, eh, because that's the whole point, is that they're ground tour. We're on a ground tour.
But having a grand tour, they might have a
isn't that for enjoying the most
and
really
fast? And we're going to.
I'm probably do some of that as well, if I can.
Okay, fair enough.
I'm going to have
We're not. Everybody watching home said he's bought a supercar.
Yes, I have. But it's that they're usable.
They're not going to be a supercar and brought that.
That's
the best idea. You can't view until sunset. But decided instead to see which was best for the blast on the Blue Ridge Parkway.
I love this bit about road quest. Just first meeting.
Looking for, we better we have that check. Great views, check. I am in a great car, and now I'm going to unleash it. Here we go.
Yeah, remember this one.
The Blue Ridge Parkway is 469 miles long. It can't all be 35 miles an hour. Come, I was right. It wasn't. It's now 25 miles an hour.
It was just for a bump.
Yeah.
It turned out that the fastest you could ever drive on this road